subscribe my channel. P. Sarala. Hit the bell icon so that you are notified every time I post a new lesson. Let us learn about triad system and motor endplate. So, triad system is very important to understand the muscle contraction. So, what is meant by triad system? Tri means three. So, here the three structures which form the triad system are the T-tubule and the cisternae on either side of the T-tubule. How the T-tubule is formed? So, the sarcolemma which covers the muscle fiber invaginates into the sarcoplasm. So, invagination, moving into the sarcoplasm, is known as invagination. So, it appears like a T. That's why it is known as T-tubule. The sarcolemma of a muscle fiber invaginates into the sarcoplasm and forms a T-tubule. So, here on a one here. So, like number of T-tubules are present in a muscle fiber. So, this is the sarcoplasmic reticulum. So, the endoplasmic reticulum in the muscle cell is known as sarcoplasmic reticulum. So, on either side of the sarcoplasmic reticulum, cisternae are present. So, these are the cisternae. So, these cisternae store the calcium ions which are crucial for the contraction process. So, these are the cisternae of one sarcoplasmic reticulum. This is another sarcoplasmic reticulum and these are the cisternae. So, the cisternae which are present on either side of the T-tubule, together these three together form a structure which is known as triad system. So, this is useful because as the impulses from the nerve or the stimulus from the nerve comes, it spreads easily and these cisternae liberate calcium ions into the sarcoplasm. And so, these calcium ions again bind to the troponin C of the actin filaments and contraction starts. That's why these are very crucial. So, T-tubule enables the cisternae to release calcium ions very easily during the stimulus. So, these T-tubules are present at the junction of A band and the I band. In mammals, T-tubule is present at the junction of A band and the I band. In non-mammalian animals, T-tubule is present at the Z line. So, this is the Z line of the I band. In non-mammalian animals, T-tubule is present at the Z line. But in mammalians, it is present at the junction of A band and I band. This is very important. You have to note, this is important for the examination point of view. Because in mammals, it is present at the junction of A band and I band. In non-mammals, it is present at the Z line of the I band. Okay, next, coming to motor end plate or neuromuscular junction. So, this is the neuron. So, this is the axon part of a neuron and these are the telodendrites. So, the telodendrites which are very close to the sarcolemma of a muscle fiber. So, these are the telodendrites. This is the sarcolemma of a muscle fiber. So, the junction between telodendrite and the sarcolemma. So, this is the junction. So, the junction between telodendrite and the sarcolemma of a muscle fiber is known as motor end plate or neuromuscular junction. So, this is the motor neuron. So, these are the telodendrites of a motor neuron and the junction between, so this is the synapse. So, this is the synaptic cleft. So, here the impulse or the stimulus will be transferred to the sarcolemma and the contraction process starts. So, these are the new motor neurons which bring the stimuli to the muscle fiber. So, another unit which is known as motor unit. So, all the telodendrites of a motor neuron, this is a axon part of a neuron, motor neuron, these are the telodendrites. So, all the telodendrites of a neuron which are supplied to a set of muscle fibers, here only a single muscle fiber, here set of muscle fiber. So the teledendrites, all the teledendrites which are supplied to the set of muscle fibers constitute a structure which is known as motor unit. So there is a difference between motor unit and motor end plate. So motor end plate or neuromuscular junction is a junction between teledendrite and the sarcolemma of a single muscle fiber. Okay. So motor unit is a junction between all the teledendrites of a motor neuron, and the set of muscle fibers is known as motor unit. So these are the two topics which are related to the muscle contraction.